YOLO conventional neural networks and the tremendous impact they had in various fields. The basic idea is to convolve an input image with multiple filters, which gives us multiple output feature maps, which we then pull to reduce the spatial dimensionality. In this paper, we are interested in generalizing this framework from 2D Euclidean space to general graphs. Graphs are very versatile and can be used to model brain signals, social networks, or transportation networks. A graph is defined by a set of nodes and a set of edges connecting those nodes. Such a graph is fully determined by its adjacency matrix W, which records the weights of those edges. From this matrix, we can compute the degree matrix D and the combinatorial Laplacian L that we use later on. Given a graph and the graph signal defined on the nodes of the graph, we can convolve it with multiple filters, which will give us multiple graph signals, which we can then pull to reduce the dimensionality. In contrary to images, where downsampling is easy, on graphs, we first have to chosen here to choose which vertices have to be matched. Second problem is how to define graph convolution. Again, in contrary to images, where each pixel has a role with respect to the central one, and this is up or right. On graphs, I don't know in general the role of that vertex to with respect to this one, and if this one has the same role as this one. Here, we don't have any orientation information. The idea is to leverage the convolution theorem, which says that the convolution is a multiplication in the Fourier domain. On graphs, the Fourier basis is given by the singular value decomposition of the graph Laplacian. This gives us the Fourier basis U and the set of n eigenvalues n analog to frequencies. We can then transform input graph signal x into the spectral domain by a multiplication with the Fourier basis U, filter it there by a pointwise multiplication with our learned filter g hat, and transform that back into the vertex domain by multiplication by u. The problem here is the n squared computational cost, where n is the number of nodes, due to the multiplication by u, a matrix of size n by n, and the n cubed computational cost of the singular value decomposition. Moreover, our filter g hat has the same size of the input, which is the number of nodes. In the spectral domain, discretized by the n eigenvalues, g hat is completely freeform and not necessarily smooth, which means that it's not localized in the vertex domain. The idea is to define g hat as a smooth function of the eigenvalues, parameterized by theta of size k, which is independent of the input size n. In this work, we define g hat as a weighted sum of Laplacian of Chebyshev polynomials of order up to k. Thanks to the recurrent solution of those polynomials, we can filter our signal x by k multiplication with the sparse matrix L, which cost is linear with the number of edges, and for the often used KNN graph, linear to the number of nodes n.